Im Namen des Volkes. Erstens.
Karlsruhe. Residence of Justice. Seat of the Federal Constitutional Court.
Absatz 1 in Verbindung mit Artikel 2 Absatz 2 Satz 1 des Grundgesetzes unvereinbar.
Join us for a look behind the scenes. Discover the Federal Constitutional Court. The basic law, the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Germany, provides the legal framework for the interactions of the highest state organs. The fathers and mothers of the basic law created five constitutional organs in 1949. Four of them have their seat in Berlin, and one resides in Karlsruhe, the Federal Constitutional Court. All state organs at both federal and state level must adhere to the basic law. This is ensured by the Federal Constitutional Court. It reviews the acts of all three branches of government, the legislature, the executive, and the judiciary. The Federal Constitutional Court has two functions. It acts as a citizen's court and as a court for state matters.
We are a citizen's court because individuals can directly address complaints to the Federal Constitutional Court. Anyone who believes that the state has violated their fundamental rights can lodge a constitutional complaint. As a court for state matters, we also decide disputes concerning the rights of members of parliament, parliamentary groups, political parties, or the federal states within the federal order. If we find that an act violates the Constitution, we reverse it. This includes the power to set aside unconstitutional laws.
Constitutional complaints make up the largest part of the Federal Constitutional Court's work. The court also decides disputes between state organs. The Karlsruhe Court is a twin court. 16 justices sit in two senates that have equal status. A chamber with three justices decides whether a constitutional complaint is admitted for decision. The justices are assisted by judicial clerks and by the court's administration. Overall, about 260 people work at the court. Half of the Federal Constitutional Court justices are elected by the Bundestag. The other half is elected by the Bundesrat. Qualified majorities are required to ensure a high degree of legitimation of the justices and to prevent a single political party from having too much influence on the composition of the court.
Es sind Richterinnen und Richter, aus ganz
the justices come from very different social and professional backgrounds. Some of my colleagues have served as judges at one of the supreme federal courts. Some were politicians at federal or state level. And some are professors of law at different universities. Sometimes former lawyers also become justices. With their different personalities, the members of the court contribute their diverse life and professional experience and their legal views to our discussions, enriching our work.
Anyone who is at least 40 years old and qualified to hold judicial office can be elected to serve as justice for a term of 12 years. Justices cannot be re-elected. This strengthens their independence. The review of actions of other state organs by the Federal Constitutional Court is one of the pillars of the constitutional order. This also involves scrutiny of political decision-making. Yet the court does not decide on the basis of political considerations, but strictly on the basis of legal standards, specifically the basic law. The justices are independent in their decisions. This is both their privilege and their duty. On average, the Federal Constitutional Court decides approximately 6,000 cases every year. What are the stages of a constitutional complaint at the Federal Constitutional Court? Most constitutional complaints are decided in the chambers. Their decisions must be unanimous. Cases raising new or very important matters are discussed and decided by the entire Senate.
Before deliberations, all justices at the Senate receive a comprehensive report, which sets out all legal issues that are raised in a case, and which deals with and presents all material that is available on these questions, so that all justices are equally well prepared. Such case reports often have 400 to 500 pages, plus numerous enclosures, sometimes up to 5,000 or 6,000 pages. This is the basis on which we prepare a decision.
In some cases, the Senate holds an oral hearing.
Then we meet here, in this room, and the parties join us for a legal discussion of the case. Afterwards, we eight justices deliberate again and then reach a decision.
In order to declare a law or a court decision unconstitutional, a clear majority of 5 votes is required.
And then we enter discussions again. We really discuss each point of the decision. This can often be quite a painstaking and lengthy process, but in the end we usually reach agreement. We work meticulously on our texts and discuss every sentence of our judgments and decisions. We go through them sentence by sentence. But looking at the older decisions, we see that our decisions actually age quite well. One can still benefit from reading many of them, even 30 to 40 years later.
Finally, the day has come. It often takes 2 years until the court pronounces its judgment.
Das Bundesverfassungsgericht.
The judgment the court pronounces here is binding on all state authorities.